You have a train to catch.
From the clip, we know the initial and final velocity, the time taken since the webs were launched, as well as the mass of the train with 6 compartments. Using the first equation of motion, by rearranging the terms, we can find the acceleration of the train in the backward direction as it slows down. We can then use Newton's second law of motion to find the force acted on the train in the backward direction using the mass of the train consisting of the passengers and the acceleration. As presented in the free body diagram, the forces that contribute to the net force acting on the train are tension of the web as well as the kinetic friction. We can find the kinetic friction using the formula mu into normal force. We know that the normal force acting on the train is equal to the mass of the train multiplied by the gravitational force acting on it. After finding this value, we can then subtract it from the net force, giving us the force of tension on the web.
Now we know that tensile strength is the max tension that a material can bear before rupture, and from this stress strain graph we know that spider webs have a tensile strength of 1.4 gigapascals. The tensile strength formula is max tension by cross section area of the web, which is a circle with 1 millimeter radius and hence an area of 5 millimeters squared. By converting tensile strength, the webs can bear max tension of around 1400 newtons per millimeter squared, and proportionally the max tension force of 5 millimeters squared comes to around 4398 newtons. Based on the total tension applied on the webs in the scene, we can divide that by 14, the number of webs, to find the tension applied per web, and the result is clearly less than the max tension that the webs can bear. And based on this, we can say that Spiderman can actually stop the train, and that the movie exhibits good physics.